parallel universes. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. Every so often I catch myself wondering about the whole grand scheme of faith. I stand in an airport, for example, watching important looking people in business suits, briefcases clutched to their sides, as they pause at an espresso bar before scurrying off to another concourse. Do any of them ever think about God, I wonder? Christians share an odd belief in parallel universes. One universe consists of glass and steel and wool clothes and leather briefcases and the smell of freshly ground coffee. The other consists of angels and spiritual forces, and somewhere out there, places called heaven and hell. We palpably inhabit the material world. It takes faith to consider oneself a citizen of the other, invisible world. Christmas turns the tables and hints at the struggle involved when the Lord of both worlds descends to live by the rules of the one. In Bethlehem, the two worlds came together, realigned. What Jesus went on to accomplish on planet Earth made it possible for God someday to resolve all the disharmonies in both worlds. No wonder a choir of angels broke out in spontaneous song, disturbing not only a few shepherds, but the entire universe. Once, from the realms of infinite glory down to the depths of our ruin and loss, Jesus came seeking, oh, love's sweet story, came to the manger, the shame, and the cross. The key word of Christmas is Emmanuel, God with us. Amen.